Hello and welcome to Craft with Sarah and the first video in a brand new series. If you've been following me for a while, you'll know that I love layered SVGs, especially dog and cat designs. That's why I've got over 130 dog designs in my SVG shop and 20 separate cats, with more being added each month. But with all of those dogs, I get a lot of questions, and this new series is going to answer as many of those as I can. I'm going to be teaching you how you can customize my layered SVGs in Design Space to make your own bespoke creations. So if maybe you've got a dog that doesn't quite fit any of the designs I've come up with, but you know that it will have this bit of this one and this bit of that one, I'm going to show you how you can merge them together. As well as that, this series is going to have a whole host of craft ideas of what you can do with the dog designs, and in fact, any of my layered designs. So for this being video one, I'm going to do the most requested Design Space question about my layered files. And that is how to take the head off of one of the dogs, for example, this Labradoodle, and put it onto the body of another dog. So I've chosen the Maltese. So in this Design Space tutorial, we're going to take the head off a Labradoodle and put it on a Maltese. Don't worry, it's easier than it sounds, and it means you'll be able to fully customize the dogs to match your own wonderful pooches. Let's get started. Here are the Maltese and the Labradoodle designs, and I'm going to put the Labradoodle's head onto the Maltese. To start with, I'm going to work with the Maltese and delete all of the existing head layers. So for now, I'm going to click the Labradoodle and then click the little eye icon next to the group name in the layers panel, and that's just going to hide it for now. I'm also going to click the arrow next to where it says the name of the file, and that's just going to make it easier to see what we're doing with the Maltese, because now all you can see in the layers panel are the Maltese layers. We need to delete the head layers, so one by one you can click on these layers in the layers panel and it will highlight it on the main design so you can see what part it is. And then if it's a part of the head, just hit delete on your keyboard. So we've got a nose, the fluff on the nose, the other eye, more fluff, head, tongue, and finally the other head layer. So now we're left with four body layers and two tail layers. We need to do something similar with the Labradoodle. So let's close up the Maltese group and hide it. Turn the Labradoodle back on. And I just did that by clicking the eye again. And then click the arrow so we can see these layers. This time we want to make sure we delete the body layers but keep the head. So it's easiest to start at the bottom and one by one just have a look, delete all the body layers, and then we're just left with the head. Okay, so let's turn the Maltese back on. Here it is. So we can't just move this over. Even if we go arrange center front and put this on top, we can't just stick this on here because you can still see some of the Maltese's head underneath. However, what I'm going to do before I do anything else is just try and get the Labradoodle head where I want it to go. So this will be a bit trial and error working out the size and the rotation. So you can drag the arrow at the top to rotate it, and then you can resize it with the kind of diagonal arrows at the bottom. And we're just going to position this until we're happy with how it looks. So you can play about to get it to look like how your dog looks. It can be easier to change the colors at this point. So I'm doing this as if it was a little, I don't know, white fluffy thing. I'm not quite sure what it would be. So I'm going to change these layers in the Labradoodle head to match the body. So let's go for a dark layer on the bottom, a lighter layer, then a dark layer, and then I've just got the eyes. Okay, so that kind of helps you to see how it's going to look when it's the same color. It's a bit confusing because we've got the Maltese head showing through, but overall I think this is okay.
So what we need to do now is take off all the bits of the Maltese head that we can still see. So let's open up the Maltese layers, click on the group in the layers panel, and then press ungroup to separate out all the layers. I'm going to close the Labradoodle group so it's easier to see the Maltese. And now we need to draw some shapes over the pieces of the Maltese that we're going to get rid of. To make it easier, I'm going to do it one layer at a time. So I'm going to hide the three body layers on top, and then I've just got this bottom one. And for now, I'm going to make it a bright colour so I can definitely see which bits I need to take off. Go into shapes and you can choose whatever shape you want. I'm going to go for a square and then click the padlock icon and drag it so that it covers all of the bits of the bright colour layer that we want to cut off. Depending on which heads you're putting on which body, you might need to do it as separate shapes. So this one actually works fine. I could cover everything up. But let's say, for example, I couldn't cover everything up without taking off something I don't want to. So I wouldn't want my rectangle to be here, for instance, because then it's going to cut off the tail, which I don't want. So if I did need to cover up two parts that aren't going to be covered by one rectangle, just make a new one and then use that second one to cover up the part you missed of the first, and then join your shapes together. So choose the first one, press Ctrl or Shift in the layers panel and click on the other layer, and then press Weld down the bottom. And that will join it into one shape. We need to make one of these rectangles for every body layer that we've got. I have four body layers in the Maltese, so I'm going to need four of these. So let's duplicate it three times by pressing the duplicate button at the top of the layers panel. And I'm going to hide those top three so that I've just got this original one. And I'm going to turn it blue because it's just easier to see what we're about to do if we've got two very different colours. So I'm going to select that blue rectangle. Press Ctrl on my keyboard and choose the red layer. You can also press Shift instead of Ctrl, it doesn't matter, they both work the same. And then down the bottom, press Slice. This will cut the shapes out of each other. We don't need any of the blue now, so I can delete both of those. And our red layer has now been split into two, so we've cut the poor little Maltese's head in half. I'm going to delete that top part because we don't need that. And now you can see we've not got any bits poking out, although actually, if we zoom in, I have missed a little bit because that red is poking out. If I drag this layer back to the bottom, there is the tiniest bit of red that's creeping out of that space. So it probably wouldn't even notice by the time we're finished. But I'm just going to slice another circle out of that just to get rid of that bit that's poking out. And if I just hide the Labradoodle head, you can see we've got a tiny piece here that I've just sort of missed. So if you've got that, then you can click on the dog layer, press contour, and then just click into any pieces to remove them. All right, so now I can click on this and either drag and drop it to the bottom of the layers panel. Remember, this is our very bottom layer, or go arrange, center back. I'm going to hide this layer now by clicking on the eye and I'm going to turn on the next one. So let's make this a different bright color. Turn on one of our squares and do the same thing. So let's make this blue. You don't have to change the colour of this, it's just I find it easier to see. Select both of those layers, the yellow and the blue, press slice, delete the blue bits and the top of the head, and then drag that down back to its original place. Again, we've got that little bit poking out, so I'm going to take that out as well. There we go. Okay, hide that one and do the next one. So it does get a little bit repetitive, but once you get to know the steps involved, it does go quite quickly. Now these are all in different places because of how I duplicated it, so I'm just going to make sure I'm not cutting off the tail. Make it blue. I've moved it down this time so it's going to cover up that tiny bit so I won't need to add the circle afterwards. So let's do a purple one for the body. Slice these. Delete the blue and the top of the head. And then drag that down, above the yellow. Then we have one left. What should we make this one? Green. Move the rectangle to where it needs to go. Make it blue so it's easy to tell the difference. Slice. Get rid of the blue and the top of the head and drag it down into position. Cool. Okay, so we are getting there. But if we were to cut this out now, all of those body layers are going to look like that, which is no good because it means you won't have anything to stick the head onto. So we need to join the new head to the old body. I'm going to undo that to put it back in position and just turn on all my other layers again. I know it's confusing that they're all really bright colours, but it will make this easier in a minute. So I'm going to click the head layer and ungroup it. And then I'm going to find the bottom head layer and duplicate it and move it over to one side. Then I'm going to select all of the head layers again, the original head layers. So click one in the layers panel, press Ctrl or Shift on your keyboard and just click all of the head layers and then regroup them. We need as many duplicated head layers as there are body layers. So in my case, it's 4. Yours might be different depending on your dog that you're doing. To make it easier, I'm going to make each of these new heads the same colour that I've made the body layers, so I know which one I'm going to stick where. And green. I can click and drag around all of them and go align centre to put them one on top of the other. I also want to put this head in the same place, so what I'm going to do is drag a box around all of the head layers, put them as close as I can get, go down to the group that has the head in there and go arrange center front. And then with that group selected, I'm going to press Ctrl or Shift, choose all of my new colored heads and go align center just to make sure everything is where I want it to be. And this is your last chance to get that new head exactly where you want. So I'm going to put it there. Now it's time to start welding. I'm going to hide the top head and the top 3 ones under that. So I've just got the red one left. And then in the body layers, let's hide everything apart from the red one again. Click the body red layer. Press Ctrl and Shift on your keyboard and choose the head red layer. And then down the bottom, press Weld. That's joined them together, so now this is just one layer. And now I'm going to hide it. Turn on the next bottom layer, so mine's the yellow one, the body and the head. Click one layer in the layers panel, press Ctrl or Shift on your keyboard, choose the other one, and press Weld. Hide that and move on to the next one. Do the same thing again. Hide it and then repeat that process for any more that you have left. All right, that's all of mine done. So now I can turn them back on again. And now I'm going to put them back to their proper colors. So how I normally do it is the solid layers that is just all one colour, I do a slightly lighter shade than the flower layers on top. But of course, you could do whatever you want to match your dog. So my bottom layer will be the paler grey. Then I've got the darker grey. Purple becomes light grey. And then the green will become the darker grey. I can now turn the head back on. I can't see it at the moment, so I'm going to press the group. And you can either drag and drop in the layers panel, or if I just undo that, you can click on the group and then arrange center front. Finally, we've got those two tail layers, which are showing at the bottom at the moment. I'm going to drag those to above the body layers. And now we've got all of our layers ready to be cut out. So this is looking really, really cool. I'm just going to check the color sync to make sure I'm happy with everything. And if you didn't see what I did there, at the top it says layers and then color sync. If you press color sync, this shows you all the colors your design is using. And I'm going to cut this out of white. So at the moment it's showing a pale gray and then the white is these eye parts at the bottom. Actually, I probably don't even need to cut them because it's going to show the white through anyway, but what I will do is cut them out just in case. So I'm going to drag these whites over to the white that I'm going to cut the body from. And that just means it's all going to cut on one mat out of one colour of cards. So I'm going to need less times to feed my mat into the Cricut. I'm going to save my progress because I always like to save before I cut something out, just in case anything happens, goes wrong. If we have to shut down Design Space for whatever reason, we don't want to lose all our work. Let's call it Change Dog Head Save. And that really is all there is to it. So some designs might be a little bit more tricky than others. It depends a little bit on the actual designs you're trying to change, because some of the flower patterns come up a bit further than others, so it might look a little bit strange if you've got gaps, or alternatively the head might not quite fit in right position, so you'll have to rotate it. If it's really not looking right, you could try flipping it. So to do that, click on it and then go flip horizontal if you wanted it to face the other way. Obviously, that looks really weird because I've only flipped the top layer.
So there you have it. You now know how you can take the head off of one of my layered SVGs and put it onto the other one. If you want these specific SVG files, the links are in the description of this video, as well as a link to my shop where you can find all of those designs. And in case you want the link now, it's shop.craftwithsarah.com. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel. As I said at the beginning, there are loads more videos coming on how to do even more with my layered files. Thank you for watching. Bye!